Hello and welcome to this week's reading vlog. It is currently Monday night. It's like past 10 p.m. and I'm just starting this reading vlog because I have been awful. I actually also just finished closing out last week's reading vlog, so it's just been a time. But we went to the vet again today because my cat had developed a limp and they think it's something and like he has pills and I don't know. We're gonna wait and see and hope for the best. But I won't bore you with any more cat talk. He's doing fine. Like he's eating and stuff. It's just he was limping. Now he's not. I don't know. And of course, when he goes to the vet's like touching his legs to see where the limp is, and he's fine. So, like, we don't really know, but it's something with his paw pads and they're swollen and stuff. So, hopefully, the medication that we have will fix that, and that will be the last of our vet visits because I have never been to the vet so dang much. But, anyways, I'm still trucking my way through this beast. I want to try and finish it in the next couple of days. I'm on page 300 or something like that. So, I think I'm going to sit here and read for the next little bit, though I have been updating my Goodreads shelves and looking at what books are coming out in 2018 and kind of making a wish list and most anticipated and stuff like that because I want to kind of get a head start. And it's crazy that I just also made a 2019 releases shelf, which is like 2019? That is ridiculous. It's almost 2020. Oh my goodness. So I might still do that for the next little bit because I'm having fun doing that. There's lots of new releases that I'm getting very excited for, and there's a ton of new releases actually coming out this year that are coming out soon because the year's almost over. What? But it looks like next year is going to be just as awesome. But Sarah J Maas books take me forever to read, so I'm gonna work on this one. I also wanted to show you guys something exciting I got in the mail. So if you guys follow me on Twitter, then you may have seen that I bought 5 new editions of Alice to add to my collection, which is already giant, but I still bought 5 more. And this is one of them that came in. Actually, 2 of them have come in, but the other one was a coloring book and I didn't know it was a coloring book, so I might return it. But this one is illustrated by Helen Oxenbury, and this was actually recommended to me by a coworker because I'm trying to collect different illustrators and I love it. I'm so excited about it. So it comes in this beautiful slip case, and we have right there are the spines. So Alice's Adventures in Wonderland and Through the Looking Glass, and the case is just gorgeous. And then I'll pull them out for you guys. So we have Alice's Adventures in Wonderland and Through the Looking Glass. They are so pretty. I am just absolutely obsessed with these illustrations. They are so gorgeous. Like, I can't get enough of it. And then I'll show you Through the Looking Glass too really quickly. I'll show you guys in my book haul, but that won't be coming for a little bit. So you get a sneak preview, but oh my God, I can't. It is so gorgeous. I'm so happy that I finally have these because I've been wanting to get it since my coworker told me about it. And I love the fact that the Cheshire Cat in this one kind of looks like my cat because it's orange. If I can actually find it here. Here we go. So look at it. It looks like Jackson and he's so cute. I love it so much. So yeah, so I'm really excited about these, but tomorrow I'm not working. I have the day off, so I'm planning on reading. I still have a bunch of editing to do because I was editing the other day and then I got really frustrated because I realized I filmed an entire review and then half of the footage got deleted and it's completely like unretrievable, which sucks so much. So I actually think what I'm going to do is film a little bit tomorrow. I'm going to film the little bit that's missing and just put it in and be like, sorry, but this, we're gonna deal with it. So I might end up doing that and hopefully I'll be able to have it up for Wednesday, but I need to do some editing and stuff. But first I'm going to read and then go to sleep. I got a package from Book Depository. I know what it is, except I don't know which one it is. I know it's an edition of Alice, but just not sure which of them. So, oh, it's a small one. Ooh, this is actually the one reason why I made this order. Of course it's blurry. This is one of the new Puffin ones. It's super shiny. Oh my God, it's so cute. I didn't realize it was gonna be this small though. When it has the dormouse on the back. There was not a moment to be lost. Away went Alice like the wind and was just in time to hear it say, oh my ears and whiskers, how late it's getting. This is so cute and I couldn't get it anywhere in Canada, so I'm really excited that I was able to find it. Look at this absolute angel. We had to prop up the bed with towels because it leans a lot because he's too big for it, but he makes it work. It's like the perfect fit. Good morning. So it is Wednesday. It's about 11 a.m. I have actually been up since 5 a.m. because I was working this morning. So I did a stocking shift. So I have been up for a very long time, but I don't really have anything planned today. I really want to try and finish this today. I'm on page 430, so I have like 300 more pages, but I just want to sit and get it done. It's such a long book and it takes me so long to read, but I really want to finish it so then I can move on to other things. But I actually kind of am planning on changing up my shelves, so I'm having a shelving dilemma. So right now I have it just regular rainbow, as you can see now that it's in focus, but I have it in a regular rainbow. And what I really want to do is, I've seen a lot of people who have, like, it goes from white and then it goes from orange and then it goes to orange and then to red, and then like it's kind of just this progression of color, because when I'm filming I sit right in this area, so what you see is like this area. So it's mostly like whites and blacks, it's nothing really exciting. So I kind of want to change it so then it's colorful down here. I was thinking about trying out a reverse rainbow, see if I like that. I don't really know what I'm going to do yet. Also, I never really showed you guys, but I moved my Alice collection back to up top there, so you can see this absolute beauty. So I think I'm going to make my bed and then read a little bit of Empire of Storms and then listen to an audiobook as I kind of reorganize my shelves and play around with that. I'm currently listening to It Is Over Here. Ow, I just stepped on something. And I Darken by Kirsten White. I'm starting this out and it's a Vlad the Impaler retelling, and it matches my shirt and the background. Oh my god, amazing. Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming a bigger thing. So I used to have my TBR by rainbow, but it looked kind of weird with the rest of the shelf rainbow and the rainbow starting there. It kind of just looked odd. And plus, I'm a mood reader, so I generally go for a certain genre. So for my TBR, it's kind of easier to have it organized by genre so then I can be like, I'm in the mood for a contemporary, and then go to the contemporaries. I finished Shacklebar! Ah! I'm so excited. I'm so happy that I finally finished it, and it was really good. I did have a few issues with it, but I did end up enjoying it as a whole. I'm kind of sad that we're done with Feyre's perspective, but I'm also glad that the story is over. I think it's time to move on to different stories, so I'm really excited to read more about Perthian. I think it's going to be awesome, and I don't doubt that a lot of these characters are going to show up in future books, so I'm quite excited about it. But I am going to be doing a full bibliobabble for it because I have a ton of notes for it. It's going to be a long one. It's going to take me forever to film. I'm already kind of dreading it, but I'm also really excited. But like I said, it was really good. So now I have decided to move on to The Last Magician by Lisa Maxwell. I actually tried starting this before I started Akawar and ended up picking up Akawar, putting this one down, but now I'm starting this one again. So I'm about 2 pages in, not very far at all, but I'm really liking it so far. So I feel like now might be the time. It takes place in the 20s, so I'm really down for that right now. So I don't know, I'm going to give it a go. So far, so good. So I'm hoping I will end up sticking with this one. I don't know where my phone is, or else I would tell you how I'm doing with my audiobook, but I am doing pretty well because it took me forever to fix my bookshelves, and I'm gonna show you that now. So ignore the fact that my pillow's on the floor. I was sitting in that chair and the pillow bugs me when I'm sitting in it, but here's what I ended up doing. So we have the whites and the browns and the grays on the top, then we have red, orange, green into turquoises, and then blues, and then purple, pink, and then black. So it's kind of a little bit of a change. The color is more centered, which I like. It's going to take some getting used to. I went through many different things that I was going to do with my shelf, but I think this is my favorite that I did. And I also ended up actually reorganizing my TBR shelves. So it used to be on these two shelves here, but now it's just the one like long shelf. It goes behind my chair a little bit too. But what I ended up doing is organizing it by genre, and then within that, organizing it by height. So we start off with contemporary and then moving into some fantasy sequels, and then moving into fantasy, more fantasy, then into retellings, and then behind here, let me just move my chair. So behind here we have more retellings and some historical fiction, and then we have some randoms, like that's sci-fi and kind of thriller-ish, and then I have my arcs at the very end. So I like this because since I'm a mood reader, it's really easy to be like, I'm in the mood for a fantasy right now, and go and pick up a fantasy. It also kind of helps me to see what I have a lot of genre-wise on my shelves. So for example, right now now I have a lot of contemporary, which is a result of it being summer recently, and I have quite a bit of fantasy, not so much historical fiction, which I should get more of since we're going into fall, and I have not much of any other genres either. So I've got a pretty good mix of stuff, but I do have definitely a bunch of contemporaries at the moment. So yeah, so that's what's going on with my shelves right now, but I'm going to go and read some more. I'm going to read a bit of The Last Magician, but yeah, I'm going to, I think, try and plan the rest of my Akawar review, and then I'm going to just read. So it's Thursday. This week has been really weird because, one, it's already Thursday, and two, I thought yesterday was Tuesday, so I actually was supposed to go out for dinner last night, but since I thought it was Tuesday, I thought that I was going out for dinner tonight and just completely forgot about it, so I'm clearly out of my brain right now. But I have another package to unbox. This has been like the vlog of unboxings because I keep on getting packages, which is amazing. I love getting packages. There is nothing that makes my day more than going downstairs and checking the mail and there's a package for me. It is amazing. But this is an unsolicited package from Disney Hyperion, so I have no clue what's in here and I'm excited to find out. All right, I'm gonna open it towards you so you can see first. Dun dun dun! I can't even tell what that is from this angle. Oh, so it's all stuff for the release of the new Alexandra Bracken book. So I believe this is a middle grade novel that Alexandra Bracken has coming out, but it is The Dreadful Tale of Prosper Redding. And I love Alexandra Bracken. She's the author of the Darkest Minds trilogy, and she is trying out middle grade now. So that's quite exciting. Oh, it has a little cat bat on the back. It looks like a real Halloween book. So this will be good to add to my list of Halloween reads. But let's look at the other stuff that we got in here. So there's quite a few of these things, but they're little broomstick pens. How fun. So they're little broomstick pens. Oh my god, that's so cute. And then there's also this. I don't know what this is. A candle? No. Neil's Witch's Brew. Let's see. I'm gonna open this up. Oh! It's hot chocolate! Oh my god! Hot chocolate just makes me think of just an amazingly cozy day. Oh my god, it just smells so good. So there's hot chocolate mix in here and then some marshmallows. Oh, now I really want it to be fall slash winter so I can just curl up with a book and a hot chocolate. How amazing does that sound? And then also in here we've got a little, I believe it's a magnet. Yeah, a magnet. So this part pops out, the part with a fox, I would believe it is, or a wolf on it. And then the last thing in here is a little tote bag, which has the cover on it, which is so cute! So thank you so much to Disney Hyperion for sending this to me. This was very unexpected and awesome, and I'm quite excited to read this. Like, look at how spooky and Halloween-y this book looks. Halloween-y. It just looks like it's going to be a great time. I'm quite excited for this, and I'm really interested to see how Alexandra Bracken is going to do with middle grade, so cool. And while I'm here, I'll just give you guys an update on how my reading has been going. So I've read only a teeny tiny little bit of The Last Magician. I was so kind of burnt out from reading Akawar that I just didn't really pick it up last night, especially because I'd been up since 5 in the morning, so I didn't have a lot of before bed reading time either. I just kind of ended up passing out. So I'm on page 18 now, and it's good so far, and I'm hoping to delve more into it because, I mean, I've read 18 pages. I can't really form a good opinion of it yet. Hello and happy Saturday. It's about 1:30 in the afternoon and I am just about to clean my room because I was filming yesterday and this is what happened. So wowzers. So this is the present state of my room. It looks like literally, I can't even describe it. Oh my god. But this just happens to me after filming, especially because I was kind of grumpy yesterday when I was filming. So I was just so tired from being up since 5 and I didn't really have a nap in the afternoon. So I was just super grumpy. So I just didn't feel like cleaning up after filming. So that's what happens. But I went to Barnes & Noble this morning and I picked up a few things. So I was going to show you really quickly. And they're obviously out in my hallway because I can't fit them in my room yet. But I'm going to try and find a spot for them. But I don't normally normally go to the States so often, but Barnes & Noble right now has 20% off for members. I think it's only certain stores, but it's the store that I normally go to. So I've been twice now, and we're going to go back for Canadian Thanksgiving weekend. We're gonna go back, and I just can't resist the Collectible Classics edition. So I'm going to be going back then, and I'm very much looking forward to it, but I definitely made a dent today. And I'm really sad because there's a lot of editions of the Collectible Classics that I can't find anywhere anymore, which kind of sucks, but I did get a lot of the ones that I really wanted, so I'm happy about that. But while I'm cleaning my room, I'm going to be listening to the And I Darken audiobook, and I kind of started Love and Gelato yesterday, not very much, but I kind of like read a couple pages of it, so I'm going to read a little bit more later today and see if this is going to be the book that I'm going to read, because I just put down The Last Magician. I'm just not feeling it. I don't know what it is, but I think I just need to try the audiobook and I might like it then. I don't know. But anyways, I have stuff to do, so I'm gonna go and do that. So I cleaned my room, as you can see. It's nice and clean. Put away the books that I got. See, we have them right here on this bottom shelf, which I think looks very pretty. There's also some more in here, and then there's one up there that I added. Now we have this happening right here. So this is my whole TBR pile, which I added to quite a bit today, actually. I also got this. You guys haven't seen that yet, but I went to Chapters as well. But I did have my TBR pile organized by genre, but I'm very indecisive, so now I have decided that once again I want it organized by color. So I'm going to do that now. My TBR shelves are definitely going to take up more space than this because I also ordered some books online, so I've just been on a major book buying binge. But I'm hoping that will come to an end soon because it's getting overwhelming. So in case you guys wanted any pointers on how to rainbow your shelves for the first time, I think it's pretty self-explanatory, but just in case you do, what I start off with is sorting out the books into color piles. So as you can see right here, this is a very small scale version since it's just my TBR shelves, but we have browns, then reds, yellows, grays, blacks, purples are right back here, greens, pinks, and then whites, and then always the biggest pile is blues. There are so many blue books. It's true on my shelves too, like blue goes all the way on these shelves and then up there a little bit. Actually, that's more so green, but it takes up like an entire shelf because there's a reason, like psychologically, I think, why they're blue. Maybe it's because blue is a common color. I don't really remember, but there's a ton of blue books. Apparently blue is just a very attractive color to pick up. But yeah, now that these are all sorted out, I just have to put them on my shelves. And really what I do is just kind of progressively try and do it. So there's no really method to the madness for this part. It's just kind of figuring out like what looks good and what kind of makes sense, like within a color is what I mean. I do it by the rainbow, obviously. So like red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. I ignore indigo because I just do. And then I do white, brown, gray, and then black. But within, it's kind of just figuring it out, whatever looks nice.
I was walking down the street the other day, trying to distract myself, but then I see your face.
Hello and happy Sunday. So I am struggling a lot with my TBR right now because it has just gotten kind of out of control recently. I just have been buying quite a few books and now it's at almost 70 books. It honestly has not been this big since I don't even know when. Like, this is the biggest it's been in a long, long time. So I'm not exactly happy with that, and I really want to reduce it, but I don't know how to go about that because I know there's the try a chapter tag, and you can do that like unhaul edition. So you try a chapter of a book, and then if you don't end up liking it, then you just unhaul the book. But I feel like judging a book on the first chapter is just unfair. So I'm kind of considering doing that and maybe reading two chapters for all of the books, or just reading one. And then if I decide that I'm not really into it right now, I'll put it into storage, like where the rest of my TBR books are, or at least there's quite a few that are in storage that I'm not really interested in right now, but I just don't really know. But just to update you guys with my reading, I decided to put down the audiobook for And I Darken by Kirsten White because I think this is another one where I have to physically read it. That has been happening a lot lately, and I just think it's because, I don't know, I'm in a really weird reading mood. So instead I started listening to Ever the Hunted by Erin Summerill, and I'm really liking it. I think what I kind of need to do is reduce the speed of my audiobook
books. So this one I'm listening to at 1.5 speed. Usually I listen to them at twice the speed, but I'm liking 1.5 the speed for this one. And I'm not very far into it, but I am liking what I've listened to so far. Also, I am still in my pajamas. It is like 1 p.m. on Sunday, but I woke up and there was a Harry Potter marathon on, so I did not change out of my pajamas, and I have just been watching Harry Potter with my mom all morning. I also actually have started reading Love and Gelato by Jenna Evans Welch. That's downstairs, but I've gotten back into it. I was kind of considering putting it down and picking something else up, but it's just after reading a really big book like Akawar, I'm like, what the heck do I read now? But I am liking Love and Gelato, so I think I'm going to stick with that. And I was planning on filming some stuff today, filming my Akawar review, but I might save it for tomorrow because I just don't really feel like it. I have that as well as an unboxing to film, so I don't really know what's going to happen, but I'm going to go now and get some stuff done instead of procrastinating.
Hello, so it is Sunday night. It looks like I haven't changed at all. I did put on clothes eventually, but I changed back into my pajamas because I'm about to go to bed, but I wanted to give you guys my weekly wrap-up first. So this is going to be a very quick weekly wrap-up because, as you guys may have noticed, I only finished one book this week, and that was A Court of Wings and Rune by Sarah J. Maas, which I ended up giving a 4.5 out of 5 stars. Sometimes leaning more towards a 4.75, sometimes leaning more toward a 4, depending on what moon I'm in, really. But I do still need to film a bibliobabble for this, but I'm hoping that will happen tomorrow. Other than that, I started listening to the audiobook for Antidarkened by Kirsten White, but ended up putting it down in favor of actually physically reading the book. And today slash yesterday, I finally started reading Love and Gelato by Jenna Evans Welch, and I am on page 73 right now. So it was a weird week. I feel like I didn't get a lot accomplished this week. I've kind of felt really unmotivated, but motivated at the same time. So I don't know. It's very odd. I'm hoping that I can change that next week because my TBR is out of control and I really need to fix that. So thank you guys so much for watching this week's reading vlog, and I'll see you guys in the next one.